The praying mantis has long been a pest management icon, but this organic gardening hero has experienced a bit of cancel culture. Their egg cases are still sold online. Later I'll explain what you need to know if you want some in your garden. Nowadays though, some gardeners say no, even eradicating them on site. Why though? And is it fair? For context, we're talking primarily about the Chinese mantis. Here in North America, this is the largest species first introduced in the 19th century. Yes, the Chinese mantis can trace its American lineage further back than many human citizens. Yet, some gardeners still point out that this species is a non-native. Going further, they call it invasive. However, this term's not appropriate. The USDA's National Invasive Species Information Center has a large database of invasives, including many insects. These are non-natives, which can result in economic, environmental, or human harm. You can look through this hit list of outstanding criminal insects, but you won't find any mantids in here. They just don't cause harm, like true invasives do. That's not to say that mantids are perfect, upstanding citizens. They have their flaws. It all comes down to their voracious appetites. In your garden, mantises will go after bothersome insect pests. Yay! But they don't stop there. They can be indiscriminate. Beneficials are not safe from a mantis. Praying mantises will eat pollinators, and even each other. This applies to both non-native and also native mantis species as well. That being said, the larger they are, the larger their prey. A full-sized Chinese mantis has no problem going after small reptiles, amphibians, and at times, even hummingbirds. Wait, hummingbirds? Oh, the metrics on that are so bad. There's no way a PR firm can spin this, man. Hummingbirds are inherently good. They are the winged embodiment of everything pure and righteous. Hence, anything that threatens the well-being of a hummingbird must be evil. And National Geographic just had to run its sensational piece exposing that wolf in sheep's clothing. Rest assured, once gardeners became aware, they promptly updated their blogs, declaring war, proceeding to crush any egg cases they could find. Myself personally, I love hummingbirds. I have fond memories of sitting with my grandma, watching the cute little birds zipping around her feeder. But I'm a pepper guy, and when I saw these destructive spots on my crops, I soon found a much bigger enemy, a true invasive, the brown, marmorated stink bug. We don't live in the 19th century. Our ecosystems continually shift and evolve, and I needed an ally that could step up to the challenge. That's where the Chinese mantis shines. These guys absolutely will go after stink bugs. As a vegetable gardener, that's enough to tip the scales for me. Maybe you're not sold yet. Well, allow me to introduce the newest invasive insect pest, the spotted lanternfly. First discovered in 2014 here in Pennsylvania, this pest is highly destructive to various trees and crops. It threatens grapevines, maples, black walnuts, and more. But fear not, this is where our downcast hero has a chance at redemption. That's right, not many animals are known to prey on spotted lanternflies, but a Penn State research project found that praying mantises certainly do. So, perhaps the matter is not as black and white as some suggest. The Chinese mantis has not lived in the U.S. since the beginning of time. It's not perfect going after animals that we love. But when the fertilizer hits the fan, mantids can be a true ally. Should you buy mantids for your garden? What type of garden do you have? Is it an ornamental, butterfly, or pollinator garden? If so, you might not see much benefit. Are you growing vegetables? Then certainly, the praying mantis could help you out. If you have 15 hummingbird feeders, then don't waste your time. But if you have 15 grapevines, then by all means, consider introducing mantises if you don't already have them on your site. If you prefer to support native species, there's always the option to buy Carolina mantises instead. These are just as indiscriminate as the larger Chinese mantises. They absolutely will eat spiders and pollinators and butterflies, but their smaller size does limit what types of prey they can go after. When buying mantises, I advise buying egg cases, not live insects. These egg sacs, called oothecae, contain anywhere from 50 to up to 400 eggs. You can buy them from specialty websites, but Amazon, Etsy, or even eBay will work fine. Here in the temperate US, any time from fall to early spring would be good times to buy them. They're designed to survive the cold winter weather, so all you need to do is attach them to some dense woody shrubs. Look for perennial plants that leaf out early in the spring, perhaps ones that attract aphids. Either way, you want these mantises to have protective cover when they emerge. You could hatch them indoors, keeping them in a brown paper bag or a sealed aquarium. It's fun if you have kids, but be aware that these insects naturally emerge as the weather warms up. If they're in your home, they may emerge before the weather outside is warm enough to support them. To store them inside in their dormant state, a refrigerator should do the trick. Once they do emerge, it's quite an amazing sight to see. I'll try to gather some and carry them to various sheltered locations to increase their odds for survival. At that point, though, you don't need to do anything else for the rest of the season. From time to time, you may spot a little fellow keeping watch. They may be brown, they may be green. As they grow, you might notice them molting, shedding the old husk of their former self, making way for bigger and better things. Ideally, you won't need to buy egg cases year after year. Try to grow some perennials in your garden. Plants with rigid stems provide structure for the perfect site. The female mantis will select a sheltered spot and will lay her ootheca, which attaches directly to the stem. She will die over the winter, but her legacy will carry on. Just be aware of this during your fall cleanup. If you aren't paying attention, you might accidentally cut down branches and discard those eggs. But if you spot one, it's easy to relocate and attach them to some other plant. As years go on, you might start to lose track of which ones are new and which ones are old. So, in the early summer, it's a great time to dispose of the old ootheca. You may even see little particles indicating that the egg case is empty. Chinese mantises might not be a perfect fit for every gardener, but they're not destructive, invasive creatures worthy of destruction. They render valuable services, especially in the extermination of stink bugs and spotted lanternflies. That's not to mention the awesome factor. In reality, these are some pretty cool creatures. Hopefully, you now know what to do if you'd like to introduce them to your garden. Thanks for taking time to watch. I appreciate your support on my channel. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I'd like to wish you happy gardening.
Nice. Let's show its face.
Okay, I can zoom in too, you know.
Zoom in.
It's pretty well zoomed in.
Okay, cut.